Press and briefly hold down the power enter button. The backlight and all the display segments will turn on. Release the button when you hear a beep. The instrument will vibrate and the alarm lights will flash momentarily. While in the normal mode select screen, press and release the power enter button to enter normal operation. If you want to operate the instrument in barhole mode, use either the air or the shift button to scroll to the barhole mode select screen. If you want to operate the instrument in leak check mode, use either the air or shift button to scroll to the leak check mode select screen. If you do not press the button for 20 seconds, the instrument will enter the mode that is displayed on the screen. If lunch break is turned on in maintenance mode, press and release the power enter button to continue accumulating time-weighted average, TWA, peak readings, and time in operation from the last time the gas tracer was used. The short-term exposure limit, STEL, reading is reset each time the gas tracer is turned on. Press and release the display adjust button to reset the accumulation of these measurements. If you do not press the power enter or display adjust button within 5 seconds, the gas tracer automatically resumes accumulating the TWA peak readings and time in operation. If the calibration reminder item in maintenance mode is turned on, the screen that appears next depends on how the calibration expired item is set. If the unit is due for calibration and the cal expired is set for confirmed to use, then the cal limit prompt will display and the alarm LEDs and buzzer will pulse several times. When this occurs, press and release the reset silence button. You will hear a beep and the startup sequence will continue. If the unit is due for calibration and cal expired is set to not use, then the fail prompt is displayed. At the same time, the alarm LEDs and buzzer will pulse several times. The fail prompt will remain on the display until the unit is turned off. The gas tracer cannot be used until a complete calibration has been performed. If calibration is not due or the cal expired is set to no effect, then the display will indicate when the next calibration is due. If the bump reminder item in maintenance mode is turned on, the screen that appears next depends on how the bump expired item is set. If the unit is due for bump testing and the bump expired is set for confirmed to use, then the test and bump limit prompt will display and the alarm LEDs and buzzer will pulse several times. When this occurs, press and release the reset silence button. You will hear a beep and the startup sequence will continue. If the unit is due for bump testing and bump expired is set to not use, then the fail prompt is displayed. At the same time, the alarm LEDs and buzzer will pulse several times. The fail prompt will remain on the display until the unit is turned off. A gas tracer cannot be used until a complete bump test has been performed. If bump testing is not due or bump expired is set to no effect, then the display will indicate when the next bump test is due. If the ID display setting in maintenance mode is on, the user ID screen will appear for a few seconds. The station ID screen will appear for a few seconds. Once the normal startup sequence begins, you will see several screens indicating the status or settings of the instrument. The first screen is the date and time screen, which appears for a few seconds. Next, the battery voltage and alarm pattern screen is displayed. This screen displays the current battery voltage and the alarm logic. A D appearing before the V indicates alkaline batteries are used in the instrument. ALH indicates the latching alarms. ALA indicates self-resetting alarms. The remaining screens are only displayed for about a second each. You will see the full-scale values for each channel, the low alarm point for each channel, the high alarm point for each channel, followed by the STEL and TWA set points for carbon monoxide. If the HC range is set to percent volume only, you will have to press and release the reset silence button for each of the previous screens to acknowledge that there are no alarms when the unit is operated in that fashion. If the gas tracer experiences a sensor failure during startup, A screen will indicate which sensor has failed. If you wish to continue, press and release the Reset Silence button to acknowledge the failure. The instrument will then proceed to normal operating mode. Once in normal operating mode, the gas reading for the failed sensor will be replaced by 3 dashes. The failed sensor should be replaced as soon as possible. If the Auto Zero Adjustment function is turned on, the gas tracer will automatically perform a fresh air adjustment at the end of the startup sequence. Make sure that you are in a known fresh air environment, free of combustible or toxic gases, and of normal oxygen content, which is 20.9%. If the fresh air adjustment is successful, the unit will proceed to normal measuring mode. If one or more of the sensors fail the fresh air adjustment, the display will indicate which sensor or sensors have failed. Press and release the Reset Silence button to proceed to normal measuring mode. The gas reading for the failed sensor or sensors will be replaced by 3 dashes. Any sensors that fail the automatic fresh air adjustment should be replaced as soon as possible. Before using the gas tracer, you should perform a fresh air adjustment. Performing this adjustment ensures accurate gas readings as long as the calibration is current. Make sure you are in a fresh air environment which is free of toxic or combustible gases and is of normal oxygen content. Normal oxygen content is 20.9%. With the unit on and the display showing the normal operation screen, press and hold the air button. On the display, you will see the message AirCal Hold Air, which is a prompt for you to continue pressing the air button. After a few seconds, the display will read Adjust Release, prompting you to release the air button. The unit will take a few seconds to adjust the fresh air readings, then return to the normal operating screen. Press and hold the Power Enter button for about 3 seconds to turn off the unit. The buzzer will sound and the LCD backlight will turn on. Release the button when the LCD is blank. The unit is now off.